So while Plasma is keep adding things and making some polishing too in the way, let's go back to the basics, and investigate how we came up on this mess design in first place. Actually, there is nothing to investigate. Everything is pretty obvious. What happens in Plasma development is that they first implement the feature A, and then they implement the feature F, skipping to fix B, C, D, and E between. That's easily explained though. You see, Plasma has largely been developed from contributors rather paid developers, meaning you can't force them to work on hashtag priorities, but they will mostly work on the things they want to work. But for the project to grow bigger and attract more users, thus more contributors too, I believe that KDE guys should also work on some of the boring stuff, change some workflows, probably break some compatibility with the past too. So what's the difference in GNOME? Three things. First, GNOME has largely been developed from paid developers, so there is a better management. Also, Alan Day does an excellent job with the communication between the design team and the contributors, so the desktop design has consistency and continuation. Second, GNOME has an ABCDEF features, it only has A and B, so you can't skip between. Third and most important, GNOME 3 had a complete rewrite, and GNOME 2 was a full design mess not much better than KDE today. Basically, Plasma 5 still resamples the desktop paradigm from 20 years ago, and it will take years for the transition to today's requirements and expectations. If you're asking me, I'd say it would be better to create a new desktop from scratch, rather trying to improve the current. It only took around 2 years for Deepin to do, with a smaller and less experienced team.
明日から私は他の店でもバイトをすることにした!
And after Chino's anime review, let's go to Plasma UX review, and I'm telling you already, I'm gonna be very picky. So, right click to open it, and the first issue here, which is a general issue everywhere in Plasma, is the poor text readability. It is not that much of a problem on this menu, but still there are some issues. One thing is the padding between the items that feels wrong, kinda like squeezed. Then, this light blue hover color also feels bad, especially over on a blurred menu. The other thing is these shortcuts labels, that for some reason are aligned on the right, like it's Arabic or something. Which might be politically correct though, because everyone outside US is an Arab anyway. Next, let's move on to the actual menu items one by one. First is the K-Runner. You know how many people have used it instead of the shortcut? Nobody! And yet, that's what KDE people thought it should be, the first menu item. Meanwhile, apart Alt and F2, we can open KRunner with Alt and space. I bet that's because Plasma users use KRunner more than the actual menu, and I'm letting you to guess why that happens. But it's not for a good reason. Second option is for opening Plasma widgets panel. That's perhaps a frequently used option, but it is again completely meaningless to be there, since we can access it from desktop editor mode. Then, there is the most weird thing ever. You see all these Alt and S, Alt plus A, Alt and D, Alt and whatever shortcuts? Using Plasma for more than 2 years and I still haven't figured out what they do. Okay, next let's go to the most serious option of this menu, which is no other than creating a new panel. Seriously now? This is an option we will probably use twice every 50 years, but let me explain you why it is there. At some point I had tried Latte Dock for a bit, so I had to remove the panel. Hopefully this option was there, because without it I'm not sure how I could restore the panel back. However, they could add this option only when no panel's available, or even better, they could just add it on editor mode only. Let's create a new panel for a moment to see some more things. And assume we had removed our original panel. So what happens is that we're gonna lose all our previous panel configurations, plus all the widgets configurations. In short, we're totally screwed. For example, here we get the default menu. And here the icons menu, which by the way it now pops up on a wrong placement just because I added a top panel. And anyway, Plasma losing panel and widgets configurations every time we restore them, is one of the most terrible things and nobody seems bothering to fix it. But whatever. So, long tap to get into editor mode and remove that panel. then configure and more options, and remove panel. That wasn't too hard, but anyway, that's how we're doing it in case you didn't know. The fourth option is the epically failed plasma activities. And what really bothers me is that even if we don't use them, their options is all scattered around everywhere. At least hide that menu item from desktop, unless we're using more than one. The next item is the customizing the layout, which is basically Plasma's editing mode, and it is the very first option on desktop menu that makes sense so far. Next is the lock screen option that looks almost okay, and next is the leave menu. And Ben on the screen, I'm asking you, why we don't have the lock screen option here instead? People will usually use a shortcut to lock their screen, but if they want to use mouse, then give them one additional step and put that option on the screen instead. And the last option is the configure desktop option. That alone is a valid property for this menu, but if we click on it, other problems are coming, and they're coming hard at you. First of all, this panel, which is an essential settings panel, it isn't even available inside Plasma Settings app. And let me tell you a story not long time ago. So a few months ago I had a Plasma update, and probably with some kind of bug, and it activated the icons on desktop. It took me more than an hour, and only after I googled to learn how to disable them, even if I had done it before in the past. That's because a smart brain like mine couldn't ever have guessed that this option wasn't inside settings. And moreover, a smart brain would never have clicked on the layout combo box for hiding the icons from desktop. Only a completely stupid brain could figure out we need to click on the layout option for removing or adding icons on desktop. So that's not a bad design, that is simply stupid design. And things like those aren't for power users but for idiots. Anyway, let's activate this for the moment and see the additional menu options. By the way, some more interesting things happen to this panel that you really don't want to know about, but let's just stay focused only on the desktop menu. So right click again, and we now get some additional items from Dolphin. And here we have a default option to create an HTML file. This is one of the best examples how this menu comes from 2005, because nobody will just create a new HTML file like that in 2020. The next option is some actions on icons like sorting and arranging, and anyway, no complaints here. Next is just the paste option, and next is to refresh the desktop view. And last is to open Dolphin from desktop, so all normal. Meanwhile, let me restore back and show you something you may missed. So I'm setting back to desktop view, and now we have this apply now button, and in the bottom we have an apply without a specific date. I really don't know the difference, but if I press on apply, what will happen? Will apply in a week? And we aren't done yet with the buttons, because now we have two options, okay and cancel, that theoretically should do the opposite thing, but in this case it doesn't matter what we'll press. Do you remember that video I had uploaded, when GNOME users see problems Plasma users can't realize? That wasn't entirely true. Even if you use Windows, or Mac OS, or GNOME, and then go to Plasma, you will instantly see all these annoyances. And I bet Plasma users might now be wondering, what the hell this guy says? Everything is absolutely perfectly made. Well, I'm not claiming that my points are valid, it is just my personal review. Originally I had extended this video for 4 more minutes, explaining how the unattractive Plasma design can make difficult for the project to attract some small desktop applications developers, like for example it happens in elementary, but perhaps that's for another time. Anyway, this video is done, but just for making a glorious exit, I will only say to KDE people to fuck it all and start a new desktop project from scratch.
Fuck it all! Fuck it all!